Hi, I'm paleontologist Dr. Richard Kissel, and I'm here to talk with you about one of the most fascinating fossil creatures we've ever discovered, the Tully Monster. And its story dates back to the late 1950s, when fossil collector Francis Tully, as he was surveying the coal mining pits of northwestern Illinois, started finding parts of an animal that the likes of which we had never seen before. As these pieces came together, we discovered that it had a long sausage-like body. Near the end of that body, it had fins. It had two eyes, but instead of the eyes being on the body, they were on a long bony stalk, kind of like a hammerhead shark. And then at the front of the body, it had a long snout, or proboscis as we say, that ended in claw-like teeth. Truly a swimming sausage with a bite. Now, we had never seen a creature like that before. There's no creatures living like that today. So it truly was a mystery. The fossils ultimately went to the Field Museum in Chicago, where paleontologist Eugene Richardson gave it its scientific name, naming it after Francis Tully. And that name is Tully Monstrum Gregarium, the Tully Monster. So how big did Tully Monsters grow? Well, they grew to about a foot in length. Now, the fossils in the collection of the Dunn Museum are of individuals that were a little smaller. So when you're looking at those fossils, you're seeing a not fully grown creature. You're seeing a juvenile. So when did the Tully Monster live? Well, fossils from the Tully Monster date to 310 million years ago. That's long before the first humans, of course, and that's even before the very first dinosaurs evolved in the Triassic period. So 310 million years ago, the Earth looked very, very, very different. The American Midwest was near the Earth's equator, actually, and it was very warm. It was a very tropical type of environment. And there was a shallow sea that stretched across the continent. It was within that shallow sea, that warm, tropical, shallow sea, that the Tully Monster lived. It swam alongside sharks, it swam alongside shrimp, there were snails, there were clams, creatures that, although they were different than the ones today, were still similar to those living today. And so those were the types of waters that the Tully Monster lived in. Nearby on the coast were huge tropical, what we call coal forests, with giant arthropods, big insects. The first reptiles were starting to take their first steps through these dense tropical forests. The reason we call them coal forests is because after they died and were buried, their remains turned into the coal that we mine today. One of the great mysteries surrounding the Tully Monster is what kind of animal specifically is it? Whenever we find fossils of extinct animals, one of the first thing that scientists do is they look at creatures living today to see if there's any kind of modern day comparisons that they can make. For example, when we found the first dinosaurs, we looked at the structures of the bones, we looked at the shapes and the numbers of the bones, and we were able to tell that they were a type of reptile. Our understanding of dinosaurs has changed, but we've always known that they were a type of reptile. But the Tully Monster is very, very different. It's one of the few animals where we still, to this day, don't really know what kind of animal it was. When it was first found, some people thought it was a type of worm, a type of slug, or another type of what we call an invertebrate animal, an animal that does not have a backbone. But as I said, the debate continues. Very recently, a group of scientists actually thought it was a type of animal with a backbone, a very primitive type of fish. But then shortly after they came to that conclusion, a different team of scientists argued that no, it's actually not a type of fish. It actually is an invertebrate animal. It is a type of animal that does not have a backbone. Which type of animal? We still don't know to this day. However, I'm sure someday we'll find new fossils, there will be new scientists with new ideas, and we'll eventually solve the mystery of the Tully Monster. Thank you so much for learning about the Tully Monster with us today. And remember, there are so many fossil mysteries to be solved. So please explore and solve those mysteries.